When it comes to commercial snow removal, look to Tovar Snow Professionals. With the largest snow and ice management fleet in the Midwest, Tovar delivers top-notch commercial sidewalk and parking lot clearing services, even in winter's worst weather conditions. With their 24-hour live office staff, certified meteorologists, and personal service, they are leaders in professional snow removal. To get a free estimate for snow removal on your site, go to baseball.tovarsnow.com or call 844-GO-TOVAR. That number again is 844-GO-TOVAR. Tovar Snow Professionals, Chicago's snow plowing leader. Tovar is an equal opportunity employer.
Throw down for Contreras. Is it plenty of time to get him?
Back toward the wall. That baby's gone. It's a grand slammer. Willson Contreras. Gone. He's hit two of them today. Pitches high to throw. Is on the line. The throw in time from his knees. Willson Contreras.
Wilson, I want to say thank you for coming out. This man cave has raised over $350,000 for Cubs fans and Cubs-related charities, and it's because of people like you who take their time out to come out here to Club 400. So thank you very much. So I was at the game at 2016 where this young catcher came up.
Where everything started.
What's that?
Where everything started.
Yeah, where everything started. Wilson's first at-bat home run. Cubs win the World Series that year. Wilson Contreras' first All-Star game, first at-bat home run. What's it like to be Wilson Contreras, man?
First of all, thanks for having me here. My pleasure to be here with my wife and my family. I think I'm blessed from God. That's a huge bless. And I thank God every single day for having me, for keeping me healthy throughout my career. I think without health, I couldn't be here. And being Wilson Contreras, just being me, just having fun and do everything for my team. That's why I think I got all this gift from God.
I know for a fact that, like, this guy plays with passion. And that's what I love about him. Like, he's given 110% every time he hits the field. I mean, has that always been – has passion been a big part of your life? Is it just off the field too, or
– Yes, I think since I was a kid, since I remember that I started playing when I was 3 years old, I've always been the guy that gives 110% for the team. And when I cross the line, I don't have any friends besides my teammates. And I don't like to talk to people or make friends with other teams. I think when everything comes to the team, you just got to look forward to win a ball game and give your best every single day.
How about playing with no fear? Every time we watch you, you're thrown behind guys on the base. We're all panicking as fans, like that ball's going in right field, and it never does.
Hey, I have, like you said, I have no fear because the worst thing that can happen, just throw the ball away. But I don't like, I'm not afraid of making physical mistakes. I'm more afraid of making mental mistakes. And I think that's why I like to throw behind runners and I play without fear.
And that's what we love about him. The guy, he's like, you know, must see TV every game he plays. I was going to ask you when it comes down to like the 2016 in Cleveland, you won the World Series. I mean, you obviously you weren't a Cubs fan your whole life, but did you realize what it meant to the city of Chicago and the fans?
I didn't realize when we won the World Series, but after, like, I couldn't believe it. Like, I couldn't believe it. I just got to the big leagues and with the World Series for a team that waits 108 years. It's pretty special. and I started I realized when that I was a world champ when I started walking out the street and the people keep saying, like, thank you for what you guys did for the city. And I realized that talking to my family, It is I mean, it's, I have no words to say, like to describe the feelings and how priceless it was the moment.
Hey, he's never going to have to buy another meal in Chicago ever again. Right?
Certainly not in Lake in the Hills, that's for sure. Hey, did you have any catchers that you admired watching play when you grew, as you were growing up?
Careful. Careful. No, I mean, I never caught before after 2011. I played my first year as a third baseman, and then I started catching. I think it was one of the best decisions of my life, and I started watching a video from a lot of catchers. I'm not gonna say one specific. And I think if you want to learn, you have to pick something from every catcher and put it together. And I think that's why I'm been getting better every single day. And if you want to learn, you got to look up to videos.
We do want to take some questions from the fans. Crowley, go ahead. We'll ask you answer first questions, Crowley.
Willson, before the season started, there was some controversy between you saying you want to be an all-star over Yadi Molina and Buster Posey. You were the starter for the all-star game. Do you have anything to say, or did they talk to you about that? Because you put your money where the mouth is. You were the one that was the all-star. So do you have anything as far as what Buster Posey or Yadi specifically had to say?
You know what? I don't have anything to say about those guys. They've been doing good throughout their careers. I'm not going to say they don't. But I say what I say because I have confidence and trust in myself. I'm not going to say anything that I don't trust you, you know? Like, I bet 100% of myself, and the confidence that I have in myself, that's why I say that.
Yeah, we believe in you. Yeah.
Willie, I don't know if you can repeat this story, but is there any way you can find a way to tell everybody at the 2000, after we won the convention, when they asked about Lester, and you're telling them to throw the ball?
Yeah. I mean, like, everybody knows. For Lester, it was hard to throw to pick to first, and I say what I say. I can't say it right now. There's a lot of kids over here. But after that, he got better. He's been getting better at it. And I think 2018, he got like 3-4 pickups. Nobody expected, but I love catching Lester.
So you've been on a tear this year at the plate, hitting home run. You're doing it all, basically. I mean, now we have we just got a new catcher. Help you out a little bit. What the wear and tear playing in Chicago with the like tonight? It's so hot out here. It's hard. I mean, it's got to be hard on you to play every single game. I know they give you days off, but, tell us about your daily regimen and how you prepare for a game.
Everything starts with the hydration. You got to hydrate the right way. You got to rest your body the night before. Personally, I don't go out. I respect so much my career. It took me so long to be in the big leagues that I don't want to mess up my career. Yeah. And then every time from there, hydration, eat the right way, workouts, then, yes, it takes a little bit of playing every day. It's going to be hard, especially in the summer. But whenever they give me days off, I'll take it. I was the guy that, I didn't want a days off, but if I want to keep playing longer at my position, you got to take some days off.
Now, tell us about your, before you started playing catcher, who is the person responsible for saying, hey, Willie, maybe you should be a catcher? Because where were you playing before catcher?
I played in 2011. I played Boise Hawks, short A. And then they brought me to Dominican Summer League for the instructional league. And then Oneri Flita, he used to be the minor league coordinator. And I was bored. The dugout wasn't playing. And then I saw catcher equipment laying on the floor, and I just put it on for fun. Just for fun. And then this guy saw me, and I tried to take it off right away, but he already saw me. So he brought me to the office, and they asked me if I wanted to be a catcher. I said, if you want me to be a catcher, I can play anywhere you want me. You're not okay. I have no fear. He said, okay, you're going to be a catcher. And then,
thank goodness, huh?
I would have to say this guy is going to be a perennial all-star for a very long time. There's no doubt about that, man. Wherever the all-star game, watch out, National League. He'll be your catcher for the next 5-7 years, all right? Yeah. We got anybody who wants to ask a question?
Thanks, Stu. Hey, Willson, thanks for being here. There's a lot of kids out here today, and my boy being one of them. And what advice could you give young fellows or young girls in their upcoming career in playing baseball and how to treat their bodies and how to stay strong mentally and physically?
At that age, I think it's more like thinking of who you want to be or what you want to be when you grow. I can't say right now, like, stay hydrated because they drink a lot of water. As a kid, we drink a lot of water. And just dream big. Keep that in yourself. Keep that in your mind. Picture yourself. Put yourself in a big picture like I did. And everything start from there. If you want it from hard, you're gonna work hard, and you're going to get there. But everything starts when you're a kid.
What was the best part of the All-Star game, and what was it like to be with, like, the best players in baseball?
That's a good question. It is priceless. I think that's something that every kid dreams with. I dream to be an All-Star. And then once you get there, it's really impressive. You turn around everywhere, and you see superstars, you see super players with super talent, super tools. And I feel blessed to be part of the National League All-Star team for 2 years in a row. And I hope I can be there every single year. But it's a blast.
Willson, how you doing? Thanks for coming out.
Yep.
MLB says let the kids play. Where do you feel about bat flips? Where is your stance? I see that smile. Is it okay as a defender or not? Where do we stand?
You know what? I think everybody has their own style of playing baseball. I don't mind the backflips, but we have to respect the other team. So if you hit a homer and you backflip, just run the bases. Don't keep walking. Don't walk like down the first baseline. But I tried to change that this year, you know, like, I was looking at my trial, the best player in the world, and I think every homer that he hits, he never bat flips. He started running, and that's why he's one of the best. But I'm not against the bat flips. I'm not against the bat flips.
Who is your favorite Cubs pitcher to catch for?
Okay, the heavy hitting questions now.
I have a couple.
Well, Kyle Hendricks' father was here, so he better watch it, right?
I gotta be careful. Now, obviously, my five starters, all my starters, I like to play for them. I like to catch for them. I'm not gonna say one name. I'm the guy. I'm behind the plate every single day, and I like to play with my team. I love them. I love the effort that they put every single day out there, and I'm gonna do well for them.
Well, speaking of that, how do you feel about this year's team and how far you're going to go?
I feel good. I feel pretty good with my team. Before the All-Star break, we talked about making some adjustments offensively and defensively. And the second half, we start pretty good. We start pretty good. We start pretty hard. And I think those four days off that we took, that they took, clear our minds a lot. And that's why we've been playing better in the second half.
Thank you so much for coming out. I was wondering, yeah, we love you. Do you want to be a Cub for life?
Yeah! If you leave it up to me, I would say yes. I would say yes. I don't want to. I wish I could play with the Cubs my whole career. I don't want to go anywhere, but baseball is a business. You never know where you're going to take you. But if you leave it up to me, I wouldn't change this city, you guys, and my team.
Hey, Willson.
I know you're passionate about Venezuela. Tell us about, I mean, I know they're going, by the way, a portion of the proceeds tonight is going to a Venezuela charity. For both Carlos Zambrano and Willson Contreras, I know you're really passionate about it. Can you tell us a little bit about what's going on out there? And it's sad is what it is.
It is sad. It is sad. And I don't know if a lot of you guys know what's going on in Venezuela, but we are living in a dictatorship down there. It's really sad seeing my country goes down as it has gone in the last 20 years. It's not safe to go there anymore. It's not safe for our families, and it is hard to keep our focus on baseball. But if you guys don't know, there's a lot of people dying of malnutrition, dying of insecurity, and dying because they don't have medicine. And that's something that is not unforgettable for us, but it's hard for us to keep the focus. It's really sad what we're living out there, and I still have the hope and faith that Venezuela is going to be back to what it was back in the day.
Hey, Willson, who do you hang out with on the team, and who's the biggest practical jokester?
The biggest practical joker? Rizzo, I think Anthony Rizzo. Yeah. He's always dancing around and playing with the guys, and he's really a fun guy. He's really a nice guy. And my favorite teammate or the team that I hang out with is Victor Caratini. I think we got along pretty well. We spend time together, and we're trying to learn together, too.
Okay, so I want to know who the filthiest of the pitchers are when they pitch to you on our team, and then who the filthiest pitchers are on the opposite team.
I think the filthiest pitcher that we have is Yu Darvish, for sure. I'd say you. He has a lot of different pitches, and everything moves like crazy. Against me.
In the National Central.
Against me, right?
Against you.
I'll say Josh Hader. Hader. I think it's hard. It's hard to hit. I'll say it. You guys can boo whatever you want, but I'd say I think Josh Hader is one of the hardest pitchers to hit against.
You guys, you know, there are a lot of people here that are a big deal at this party. You've seen them all around, Ronnie Woo, everyone. No one bigger deal than my newest friend, Amy, who was the ring bearer for Chris Bryant.
What's the biggest lesson you learned from David Ross?
Biggest lesson from Davey. I mean, Davey always was around my side when I got called up. And there was a game that we were playing against Seattle Mariners. And I called the wrong pitch, and somebody hit a homer, and he came in the side. And he asked me what the situation was. Then at the end, he told me that everything happened for a reason, and I'm going to make way more mistakes than I did that day. But we learned from it, and we keep going. So David Ross is really a special guy.
Two more.
Hold on. Real quick. What do you like more, throwing out a base runner or hitting a home run?
Both. I think throwing out a base runner is really fun. It's really great. And it's even better when you pick up a runner on first. I think that's my favorite part. And hit a homer for sure. That way you can help the team to win ball games.
As we always do, final question from a kid.
Thank you for calling me a kid.
Oh, well, baby face.
Can you take us behind the scenes a little bit? Like, what kind of conversations do you have with an umpire when you're catching and maybe they're giving the other team calls but not giving, you know, your team a call? How do you walk that fine line without showing them up?
There's a lot of umpires that don't like to talk. There's umpires that like to talk. And I'm a guy that I'll talk if they talk to me. So it's really hard to create a relationship with the umpire because they think they're always right. And even if you ask any type of question, they would say no. They wouldn't give you an answer. There's a lot of umpires that they're mean, but I love Joe West, by the way. I love him. I think. He's a really, really great guy.
All right, we're going to do one more question. That's it. And then we're going to do two quick auction items with Willson up here, and then he's got to go. So we'll give you.
Who's your favorite teammate on the Cubs?
The kids bring the hammer, don't they?
Yeah. Favorite teammate on the Cubs. Man, it's hard to pick one. It's hard to pick one because I'm a guy that get along with everyone. And I love my teammates.
Sure.
And I love to play with them. We have fun together. We win together. We lose together. But I can't pick one.
All right, we're going to auction Mike Wilson's up here. Two items real quick. He's got to go. Sean, first of all, what's our first one? We got the Mother's Day gear. Well, your Mother's Day gear right here.
Arizona, cause my money is spent on a goddamn ring. Neither party is mine, not the jackets or the elephant. 20,000 Nicky Puffers in the corner of the cell block, but they